Okay. Welcome, everybody. We're really excited to be here. Thank you for joining us for the Article Enforcement Workshop, MSU 2017. My name is Will Fox. I'll start with some thanks to people who helped bring this together. First, the organizers, Professor Andrew Barto, Dominic Rico, Sean Norn, Tom Scholl, myself, and the tireless Carlos Forenza, thank you. As well as our advisors, Ken Goldberg, Peter Aguilar, and Roberto Calandra. And I should add thanks to the NIMS organizers who, on very short notice, helped us set the stage for this. This is really good for us, and I hope that the previous and first act will have some fire in the panel in the last act. Thanks to our sponsors, who very generously supported some of our activities, Intel and Google Recon. Thanks to our invited speakers, so Peter Bill, Matt Botvinnik, Emma Brunskill, Jan Peters, Dora Puka, Ruben Schmidhuber, and David Silver. So we're going to try something new here. Because we try to bring really a selection of professors from very diverse fields and viewpoints. But when you're such a senior professor, it's easy to sit on your laurels, and you need some young researchers to challenge you. So we have these fine young researchers who submitted challenges for some of the speakers, which will be presented as questions. At the end of the talks, for which they will provide the answer. So it's an experiment. We'll try this format, see how it goes. Hopefully it's good and it catches on. Thanks for everyone who submitted. We had 30 great submissions, and sorry if some of you who submitted and we're not accepted are here, but so good submissions. We accepted 20 papers, and six of them will be presented today as talks. The rest as posters are on the wall here. So we have a little time to maybe set the stage again with some of the ideas of why we're here. So what is a hierarchy? So one way to think about it is, it's a kind of modularization of the problem or of our solution. And it's specifically a modularization where models have the specific relation that some are called high level, some are low level, and the high level models sort of provide a global context for lower level modules, which are more local in their scope. And also, lower-level modules sort of take care of the details and sort of abstract in a way for the higher-level modules to behave more closely and not care about the details. Specifically, if we're talking about, I should say that hierarchy appears in a lot of places. We have hierarchical clustering, we have hierarchical state abstractions, we have hierarchical generative models. But specifically, we're talking about hierarchical reinforcement learning. So what does that mean? So we're talking about agent behaviors that are hierarchical. So to specify what we just said, the high level will be the why of the behavior. We'll be more aware of the global task, of why we're doing what we're currently doing, provide this context of our behavior. Whereas the low level is more of the how. It's more aware of the particulars of what's going on right now and how to behave there in order to achieve that global context. And then we can maybe hope that the high level sort of generalizes better. So if it abstracts away the details, maybe it can be more general and apply to different contexts and different kinds of details. It doesn't care about all the variability. Whereas the low level But the opposite captures that variability, which could be important in specific cases. So why HRL? So there's a lot of great answers, and I'm hoping we'll do some of them today. But just a few of them are that HRL is structured implementation of our control policies, which is sort of badly needed, right? If we want to extend our policies to richer domains with larger input spaces, larger output spaces, control spaces, we kind of need that structure if we don't want our number of parameters to grow too large. It's also can be considered as memory. So that context that we talked about is a sort of memory of where am I, what am I doing right now? And it's a structured form of memory. So unlike general RNNs, for example, it has a structure that may be easier to learn. And again, the high level generalizes. So we'd like our policies to generalize to new situations that can be achieved by this abstraction. And the low level could transfer. So if we have different tasks, maybe they share the same kind of local structures that can allow us to reuse low level sub behaviors, skills. Of course, there is a potential of interpretability, because we humans think in hierarchies. We think in this form of modularization and abstraction. And if we can capture the same structure in our artificial intelligence, maybe we can communicate better with it, and we can understand better what it's doing, why it's doing, what it's doing, and so on. That's a big challenge. So, allow me to introduce to stage David Silver. So David, you won't remember this, but the first time we met, we were presenting posters in the conference side by side. We actually, the poster was in HRL, very familiar. And so it was very inspiring. And actually, we took your ideas and took them back and thought about them for days on the neat algorithm that we discovered at NAT, but then skipped us. So the aftermath of that is that NAT and both friends I was working with and David are now in DeepMind doing awesome stuff, so that's here today.